time about a flippin' weirdo that was at the bar the other night. He was a damn predator. Not all men are like this. Not all men are like this, thank goodness. Or else we'd be in trouble, ladies. But I just wanted to put this up here to inspire you to protect those around you, stand up for your girlfriends, or even a girl that you don't even know. Enjoy. All right, so we're gonna do story time about the freaking D-bag the other night. So we're in a Saddle Bar in, it's like Solana Beach, Encinitas-ish. So we walk in, it's just a dick fest, like a literal dick fest. Literal, in every sense of the term dick fest, it was that. So we go in, five of us girls, and it's like dropping fresh meat into a gator exhibit. Like, it was a little sketchy. So we go to the bar to get a drink, and there's this freaking dude who's probably like 50, 49, something like that, standing by the bar, and I just see him staring at each of us, like his own little moment on everybody. And apparently he's trying to talk to us, and I didn't hear him. My friend was like, oh, this guy's saying, like, hi, 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 like, over and over again. I was like, all right, well, I didn't hear him, so I'm just going to keep pretending that I didn't hear him. So anyways, go back to our little table. He comes over, or no, I'm sorry, at the bar, he goes, so why are you here? And I was like, what do you mean, why does anybody come to a bar? Like, what the fuck kind of question is it? What kind of question is that? Like, excuse me? Like, why the fuck are you here? Here, next to me, why are you here? So, he's like asking us the weirdest question. Like, you can already tell he's, like, three sheets to the wind. So then, we, like, I don't know, guys, like, take a hint. Like, if a chick is very short with you and then turns around and is, like, ignoring you and talking to her friends, she ain't interested. Ain't gonna happen. So we get our little drinks, we go sit down, and makeup on my face. So we go sit down, we get our drinks, we go sit down. He comes over to the table and he says the same question again. He's like, why are you guys here? And I'm like, oh my God. Is it Groundhog's Day or am I taking fucking crazy pills or both? I don't even know. What is happening? What's happening? Why is this guy here? Why is he still here? Like, pick up some social cues. So he starts asking all these stupid questions, and then one of my friends starts entertaining him. I'm like, oh Lord, she done it now. Now he's not ever leaving. And so then that fizzles out. We all ignore him again, and he's just sitting at the table like this, staring at each of us, and we're not even looking at him. We're talking about whatever we girls talk about. Like, we're talking about stuff, not him. And he goes, just out of nowhere, no one's talking to him, no one's looking at him, no one's nothing. He goes, just let me know if I'm being an asshole and I'll leave. And I'm thinking to myself, oh, fancy, it's your chance. This is your chance to fucking tell him. Nobody here is interested in talking to you. We're trying to have a girls' night. Can you fucking fuck off? I didn't say anything because I was like, this guy's so drunk. If I engage this guy, he's going to start talking. It's not going to end. So I just ignore him. I'm like thinking, this guy's got to get the picture. Like, there is no way he doesn't realize that nobody here wants to talk to him. So then he slides into the bench at the table next door. And it's like 6 inches away because this place is tiny and it's a dive bar. Then my friend, I'll leave names out of this actually. I may have influenced her to take a shot. Didn't realize she was such a lightweight. Didn't also realize how inebriated she was either. She hides that shit real well. She went from zero to fucking hero real quick. So then they're talking. I'm like, is she seriously entertaining this guy? I'm like, asking her, I'm like, is she, this guy is like so, like, not only physically not her type, like, you just know, like, okay, he's, like, 50, in his 50s, she's young and hot, like, and he's also weird, like, he's so weird, like, he's, I don't know, so I'm just like, okay, no, this is, like, this guy's a freaking creeper, like, I freaking can sense it, and so then she's still talking, and then I look back, like, 15 minutes later, and she's, like, making out with him. I'm like, What do I do? What do I do? And I'm like, you know what? She had red lipstick on too. It was like all over her face. I'm like, I'm gonna do some recon after this shit's over. So then I look back 10 minutes later, and she's, like, asleep on his arm slash lap. And I'm like, oh. And he's, like, rubbing her arm. Like a boyfriend would do if his girlfriend was fucked up. But, like, this guy ain't no boyfriend. Like, this guy just met her. Like, he's just hanging around, being a nasty bottom feeder, just waiting until she's too drunk to, like, make her own decision. Well, little does he fucking know, I'll rip his fucking nuts off if he tries anything with any of my friends. So, anyways. Worked up there. I'm getting a little worked up thinking about it. So then I go, hey, honey, give me your cell phone. Do you have Lyft or Uber on here? And so she had a hotel and something. Okay, I'm gonna have to get in the hotel, the car with her and take her. Maybe let's see how fucking drunk she is. Like, trying to figure this out. Okay. So then I grab her phone. I call Lyft. I'm like, I got your Lyft. She had no idea the address of her hotel. So I had to do a little bit of research on my phone. Found that. Plugged it into Lyft, like, good. All right, we're good to go. So I'm like, all right, your Lyft is here. We got to go. He starts getting up. This motherfucker starts getting up and helping her up. I'm like, no. I got it. I'm a strong girl. Got it. So we get up. We're going outside. And the door guys, the dudes hanging out, they're all fucking looking at me. Because this guy's trailing behind, like, still trying to, like, help and stuff. Like, we're, like, this is a team effort. And so then I'm putting her in the Lyft, and he's starting to get in, and I put her in the Lyft, I go, okay, what's your phone number? I'm gonna put in my phone right now, if you're, and, oh, by the way, I forgot to say, I asked my friend, I said, I pulled her aside, I said, do you want this guy to go to your hotel with you? Like, straight up, he is nasty, he is slimy, he's a scammer, he's a weirdo, and with no hesitation, she was like, yes, he is coming with me, and I was like, shit, girl, okay, well, if that's what you want, all right, don't let me stand in the way. So then I put her on the Lyft, and he's, like, going out there all, like, excited, like, look what I fucking just bagged, because my friend's hot, she's hot. And then I'm like, okay, you know what, sir, I'm gonna need your phone number. So I pull out my phone, and I'm like, look at him, like, and he goes, 85, and I'm already like, oh, fuck. Oh, really? You don't know your own phone number? Classic. And I'm like, all right, 858. Mm-hmm. And he's like, no. He goes, 619-858. I'm like, excuse me. That's not, what? That doesn't even, if you're from San, you know, it doesn't even make sense. And then he goes, 405. I'm like, you know, you don't know your own phone number, sir. Like, you don't know. And then he starts looking at his phone, like he's going to find his phone number in his phone or something. Like in his contact, like his own contact, he's going to find his number or something. I don't even know what's happening. I'm like, okay, you know what? Let me see your ID. I'm going to take a picture of that. Since you don't know your phone number. Like, okay, maybe you're that drunk, but like, fuck. Whoa. Let me see your ID. He don't have one. He's not pulling it out. One of the two. So either he didn't know his phone number, which is a red flag, or he was trying not to give it to me. Even bigger red flag, okay? And then he wouldn't even say, so you know what? We're fucking done here. You need to fucking leave. This is not happening. You're not going with her. I'm not going to let it happen. Kick rocks. Get the fuck out of here. Sayonara, weirdo. And then I continue making sure she's in the car, talking to the, like, Lyft driver, blah, 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 and, like, trying to, like, figure out how drunk she is. And she's, like, too drunk. Like, she can't even hardly walk straight. Like, she, like, falling over in the seatbelt, all this stuff. I'm like, okay, I gotta go get my purse. I gotta go with this bitch to her hotel, make sure she gets in her room safely. And this motherfucker, he's still standing outside the car like he's got a chance. And he's just standing there. And I look at him and I'm like, and he goes, so I still can't go with her? And I'm like, no, you can't go with her. Get out of here. You don't even know your number. Get. Like how you tell dog, like, to get away from food. Like, get. You better get. And so I'm fucking saying, telling him, and then he's like, okay, and he, like, runs inside. Like, what a freaking creeper. What a predator. That is the shit we have to deal with at bars, and y'all wonder why girls, like, when a guy comes up, that's not the only creeper of the night, too. I'm not even telling you about the other one that we called bodyguard. Like, just sitting at the table, and just staring at me like this. Drunk women. Like, I don't have fucking time for this. Like, this is why women sometimes can be real nasty when you walk up and you're not getting the hint, when they're not really paying attention, and then you get pissed and you're like, well, your pussy stinks anyway. That's why we're fucking rude. Because of that story right there. Except, good thing I was there to help my girlfriend, because a lot of girlfriends aren't there for other, there's just drunk women, and men prey on that, and, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know, just, and then I'm walking back inside, and door guy and the other guy were like, dude, much respect, like, I was a freaking creep. I'm like, so why didn't you come over and help me with it then?